The National Bureau of Investigation in the Philippines subpoenas tech journalist Art Samaniego to answer allegations that he was behind the data breach of several government agencies. Nico Bawa reports.
The NBI Cybercrime Division served a subpoena for Manila Bulletin Senior Technology Officer Art Samaniego. Samaniego is being asked to explain the allegations of the newspaper security data officer Elias Kangkong that he instructed his subordinate to hack websites to use as content for his articles and social media accounts. The Manila Bulletin confirmed that both Samaniego and Kangkong are suspended.
Manila Bulletin is conducting its own internal investigation just to check on the veracity of the allegations against one of our employees.
UP Journalism Associate Professor Danilo Arau believes Manila Bulletin also has some explaining to do. He is questioning why Samaniego was allowed to keep his job as IT head after facing a hacking complaint in 2006 from a rival publication.
The challenge for the Manila Bulletin is to explain what happened way back in 2006. I mean, we can understand if Art has decided to publicly assume responsibility for fear of prosecution because the case was settled. What did the Manila Bulletin do between 2006 up to now? Because he still retained his position as head of the IT department.
Manila Bulletin's Vice President Reynaldo Rafal confirmed that there was a previous complaint against Samaniego and explained that the public apology was sufficient.
It was already settled as per records, no? Kung nagkaroon ng apology at tinanggap naman na inquirer, I don't think there's a problem with that.
The Philippine Daily Inquirer published in 2006 the public apology as part of a compromise agreement between the newspaper and Samaniego's camp. Samaniego, meanwhile, has released a statement saying that he will fully cooperate with the NBI's investigation so that he can clear his name. The NBI says some agencies and private entities have coordinated with them regarding the website hacked by Kangkong. He admitted that he was able to hack 93 websites.
Definitely part ng aming validation process, at verification process, we'll send official correspondence sa mga website nito to determine ano ba yung nangyari, whether or not yung allegation ba na to is totoo o hindi.
The NBI is also waiting for the cyber warrant so they can proceed with a digital forensic examination of the gadgets seized from the hackers. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.